I am joined by the guru of prophets, the Dalai Lama of prophets, the Gandhi of prophets, none other than the very handsome, the one who stole Joseph's coat of many colors, that his brothers almost killed him, but he managed to sneak it out of Egypt. The prophet of men. The very handsome and precise and amazing man of God, my brother and my friend. Happy New Year, sir. Welcome, welcome. You see, we did like a TV show. But God is good. God is good. He traveled just to come and support and be here, and so that we can cross over together. Now
Amen.
We are all blessed. We are blessed.
Hallelujah.
We are
Amen.
Blessed.
Let me use this opportunity to express my love, my proof, and you know it. I'm not saying it because
You're going to make me blush.
No, Aww. That's the truth. Listen, nobody.
Oh, look at them. Please continue.
Now you took your words out of my mouth.
That's the only way.
The truth is,
prophet, I hear the Lord saying.
Okay. So but listen, okay. So
no, I'm joking.
We have started our end of year spiritual exercise, and yeah. I was there on Wednesday.
Yeah.
You know, I think I had finished praying. I slept. I woke up and I saw missed calls from him, and he said, "My brother, where are you? Please get on the next flight." I'm like, "Wait, next flight from where? Ghana, Accra, to where?" He said, "I need you to come here." I was praying and listen, I just need you. And for a second, I'm like, who can say no to Dr. Lovie?
This guy.
He's the only person that could get my spiritual father to break what he told me that God says. Because he said, God is telling me this year you are crossing over with me. Last year I was out of the country preaching, even on the 31st, last 2 years. But he said, God said, this year you must be here. So I said to him, "My brother, you know what? I don't have a problem. But let's talk to Baba John." So I gave a call. He said, Lovie. He was on the phone. For about 3 minutes, and he says, "Let me talk to God. Give me 10 minutes." In less than 3 minutes, he calls me and said, "You can go. The way is
clear." Amen.
Amen.
Why am I saying this?
Amen.
I'm saying this because you see,
yes,
you cannot deny grace mm-hmm. when you see one.
Come on. Amen.
You cannot. And you don't have to talk about it. It is so obvious. It is so evident. And I was telling that man of God, listen, my relationship with you is not based on anything physical.
Yeah.
And I need people to get that.
Yeah.
And I know, because I felt the spirit mm-hmm. around people in here, those that are from afar, that are connected. It's not about who he is or what he can give materially, but it's about the spiritual things. I told him, I was traveling before I met him. But the very moment, second I sat on his set, it changed my life.
Amen.
Amen.
Hallelujah.
And we are talking about Mama T being a giver. Listen, the first time I came, the first person to give me a good, I showed it to you.
Yes,
she
yes.
came and said, "Prophet, this." I spoke for her on Zoom. In less than 10 minutes after I was done, my phone beeped. You see, you get certain messages and you check it twice if you are reading right. I'm like, "Wait, is it 1,000 or is it 1,000 or is it 100? I'm like, I was shocked.
Yes.
Amen.
But for a second, I'm like, okay, no wonder she's the daughter of Prophet Lo. Amen. So, man of God, this was just by the way, but
can I testify? When I went to Ghana, no, this is true. When I went to Ghana for the first time,
okay, this testimony, you can keep it.
Yes, I went to Ghana.
Where are you coming from?
I went to Ghana, and I was supposed to go buy some things to bring back. And when I went to the store, I realized that I don't know where I put my wallet, and I had not changed money or something. I don't know what it was.
I was flying out that moment.
So I did. So I had no opportunity to change money or anything.
And it was a Sunday.
It was a Sunday. Prophet Obed just showed up. "Oh, my brother, first of all, he bought me Gucci shoes." He said, "Oh, you like," because I looked at his shoes. You know me, I praise everybody. I said, "Prophet, this kind of shirt that has flowers, like, you know, you look like, you know, those Victorian kind of shirts. I have one that I'm still waiting to wear. It's just at home." He brought all this. I was like, "Prophet." The next day he comes in, he brought me all these gifts. I'm like, So why is this guy has the same spirit I have? Why is he like that? I called him, Prophet, I'm leaving tonight, this and this. He said, don't worry, I'll take you there. He just showed up, picked me up, took me to the market. Everything I wanted, I just saw him, he did this, you know. He removed it, I said, is this guy a drug dealer? Or is it a gospel dealer? Because the stature was so big. Anything that I wanted, he bought for me. And I told him, you know, there's a dictator in Africa that died some years ago. His name was Idi Amin. Idi Amin went to England and the queen like treated him so well. Mm. So because his English was not great, he looked at the queen and said, I will revenge this. So they were shocked. What do you mean revenge? So I looked at him and said, this one, I will revenge. I will revenge. So what we are trying to say is this, the goodness of God,
amen,
will cause you to praise.
Amen.
It will cause you to praise.
Amen.
There are divine connections that will come that will force you to praise God.
Amen.